Welcome to Engineering Drawing Lab. So before midterm, we have been conducting lab that focused mainly on making 3D views or extracting views from any object or assembly that was provided according to either third angle of projection or first angle of projection manually. For the post-midterm lab, we will be working on a software to create parts, assemblies, and extracting views. The benefit of working on a software is that we can easily edit or modify parts without erasing the whole part or geometry as we used to do manually. There are two types of softwares. One are solid model softwares, which are used for making designs and complete parts. These include Creo, SolidWorks, Pro-E, and so on. The other types of softwares are used for analysis and simulation, and these include ANSYS, COSMOL, Hypermesh, etc. For this lab, our focus will be on Creo Parametric, which is a powerful software used to create complex designs with great precision. In Creo, the design process mainly consists of sketching, converting the sketch into features and parts, assembling different parts, extracting views from the parts, manufacturing the final part or assembly. All these steps are divided into different modes of Creo, which you can see here on the screen, that is part, assembly, manufacturing, drawing, and so on. So that was just a brief intro of the software. Now let's start working on it. I will first cross it so that we will be able to start it again from the beginning. If you have already installed the Creo Parametric software, you will see on the desktop that it appears as Creo Parametric. If it isn't available here, you can search it here. You can write Creo Parametric, it will appear, and you have to double click on it. Once it opens, you can see that it shows an error here. This might be present in some of your softwares, or maybe it might not be present. If it appears, you simply have to click on the yes, which means that do you want to continue running script on this page? Yes, so it will disappear. Now, to start, we have to click on the new, which means that create a new model. When you click on the new, you will see this pop-up window which appears. You can again see here part, assembly, manufacturing, drawing, and so on. For this lab, we will be focusing mainly on part. Then we will move into the assembly and finally into the drawing. As you can see that the part is already checked, so that means that if we click on the yes, we will be into the part region. Here gives its name, that is part 001 by default. So if you want to give it your own name or your registration number or the name of whatever part you are designing, you can simply enter here. Once you click on the OK, this screen will appear. This area is your drawing area, which means that you will draw or make or sketch parts here. This is your model tree, which shows that whatever working you are performing here, it will be shown here in sequence wise. For the drawing area, you can see three different planes. This one is top plane, this one is right plane, and this one is front plane. So you can choose any one of the plane on which you want to sketch. Again, we can see that some of the commands here are inactive. So for the first, we have to go into the sketching mode, for which you have to select the sketch. Once you click on the sketch, this pop-up window will appear, which will ask you for the plane to select. You have to select a plane on which you want to sketch. Let's suppose I select front plane. When I click on the right click on the front plane, you can see that the right plane also gets highlighted. That means that my sketching plane will be front, and for reference, right plane will be used. Your front plane will be acting as x-axis and your right plane as y-axis. You will be able to learn about it more in the coming lectures when we will be moving into the extrude section. For the time being, we will click on the sketch, you have to right click on the sketch button. When you right click on it, you can see the x-axis and the y-axis. Now, in order to make this plane parallel to the screen, I have to select the sketch view from the graphics tools. These are the graphics tools which we will be using every now and then with the passage of time. You have to click on the sketch view which shows orient the sketching plane parallel to the screen. Once you click on it, you can see that this plane becomes parallel to the screen. So starting from the very basic entity, that is line, you can see here it shows the sketching parts, your sketching modules. Here it shows the editing components, then the constraints, dimensions, and so on. We will start from the sketching, and in the sketching from the line. You can see that there are two different types of lines. One is line chain and one is line tangent. We will start with the line chain. You have to right click on the line chain. Once you right click on the right chain, you can see that a small cross appears on the cursor. That means your line command is active now. You have to click from where you want to start the line. Let's suppose I click here, you have to right click. Once you right click, that will be the starting point of your line. Now you can end it wherever you want, and that will be the ending point of your line. Let's suppose I want to end the line here. I will again right click. Once you right click, you will see that it appears to be the ending point of the first line, but the starting point of the second line. And again, you can click somewhere to end the second line. If now you want to break this connection, you want to draw the third line independently, that shouldn't be connected to the previous line. So for that, you have to press the scroller of the mouse slightly, the center button of your mouse, that is scroller, you have to slightly press that. Once you press that, the connection of the third line with the second is broken. Now you can draw the third line wherever you want. Let's suppose I want to start the line from here. I will again click here. And let's suppose I want to end here. I will right click here. Again, I want to break the connection of the next line from the previous. I will click on the scroller of the mouse. Once you click on the scroller of the mouse, you can still see that the cross is appearing on the cursor, which means your line command is still active. If you want this command to become inactive, you again have to press the scroller of your mouse. Slightly again press the scroller of your mouse, and once you click that, you can see that your line command is no more active. Now, as I have made the line command inactive, you can see that number of dimensions are appearing on the screen according to the rules which we have studied previously. You can see the dimension lines, the arrowheads of it, and how the dimensions are mentioned. Now, if you want to change the dimension of a certain line, let's suppose I want this dimension to be 200 instead of 232. So you have to right double click on the dimension. Once you have double clicked on the dimension, it will become black. You have to now backspace and now enter the value that you want to give. Let's suppose it is 200. Once you have entered the 200, you have to press the enter key of your keyboard. And the dimension of the line has been changed from 232 to 200. Similarly, if you want to change the dimensions of this line, again, you have to double click. Double click the right button of your mouse, backspace the dimensions, enter the dimensions of your own choice. Let's suppose it be 90. And the new dimensions will appear. So this is how you can change the dimensions of the line. The second type of line is the line tangent. So we will be practicing the line tangent after we study the circle, because you can make a line tangent to a circle. Now if I want to make my drawing area clear, so I have to delete the lines that I have already drawn. For that, you can select the line and you can select the line and press the delete button from your keyboard. The line will disappear. Again, you have to do the same. So all of your lines are disappeared. Now let's move to the second entity, that is rectangle. There are different types of rectangles that you can use in Creo Parametric. Let's suppose we start with the corner rectangle. Corner rectangle means once you click on that, a cross will appear with the cursor, which means your rectangle command is active. You now have to click from where you want to start your rectangle. Let's suppose I want to start my rectangle from here. I will right click here and you can see that a rectangle has been generated with the cursor on the other edge. That means that will be the end point of the rectangle. If I want to stop, or if I want my rectangle to be this large, I have to click again on the mouse, the right button, and the rectangle will end. Again, you can see that you have not made the rectangle command inactive. In order to make the rectangle command inactive, you have to press the scroller of the mouse. Once you press the scroll, so your rectangle command becomes inactive. Again, you can do the dimensioning as I told you before for the line command. Right double click on it, backspace the dimensions provided, enter the new dimensions that you want to enter. Similarly, you can change the dimensions of this side also. So this is how you can make a rectangle. In order to delete what I have made, either you can select and press the delete button from the keyboard, or if you have large number of entities, then you need to start from here, right click on the mouse button, drag that for the whole screen, leave it, and once you leave it, you can see that the color of the whole rectangle has been changed. That means the whole rectangle is selected. You can now press the delete button from the keyboard. Okay, so that was corner rectangle. In order to study the slanted rectangle, that is just the same. But you have to divide the you have to identify the first point, the second point, and then your rectangle will be slanted to that line which you have drawn. It can either be upside or downside for whichever side you want to draw. Again, the procedure is the same. Click on the first point, the second point, and the third point will define the length of your rectangle. In order to make the command inactive, you have to press the scroller of the mouse. For changing the dimensions, you can follow the same procedure, 100, so you want to make it 200 or 300, you can just double click on it, enter the dimensions, and then click on enter. Similarly, you can change these angles for whatever you want to change. Let's move to the third rectangle type, that is center rectangle, which means that your center will be specified first and then your rectangle will appear. So this is how we make the center rectangle. For example, if you are given a point and you are asked to make a rectangle against it, so you have to choose out of the types of rectangles, you have to select the center rectangle, you have to click on the point and then draw the rectangle accordingly. To make the command inactive, I have to press on the scroller and then you can change the dimensions provided. To clear the space again, I will start from here, right click, drag, leave here, all the rectangles are selected, click on the delete button from the keyboard. These lines didn't get deleted, so we will again select it and delete it. Select the line and press the delete button. So the fourth type is the parallelogram. You can simply draw a parallelogram at whatever angle you want. So this is how we can make parallelogram, and again you can change the dimensions and the angle that you want to give. Let's suppose this angle be 50 or 55. So you can change the angle accordingly. To delete it, you have to select all and press delete button. You are advised to practice the line command and the rectangle command before you go into the other commands. Pause the video for a while and practice these commands for better learning. Once you are done with that, we will now move on into the circle. There are again four types of circles which you can draw in Creo Parametric. First is center and point. Once you select that, that means you will specify the center point first, and the second point will identify the radius of your circle. Let's suppose it be this. To make the command inactive, you have to press on the scroller again. Now you can change the diameter of the circle accordingly. Let it be 77. Press the enter and you can change the diameter of the circle provided. To work on the concentric circle, concentric circle means that you will be having a single center point against which all other circles will be drawn. Concentric circle will be only made if you have a center point available. For example, I have made the command active, but it isn't working here because it cannot allocate any center point. Now if I click on the center point, so the concentric command will become active and you can draw as many circles as you want of different radii generating from the same center. You can then edit the diameters accordingly. So this is how concentric circle works. To make the working area clear, again we have to select all and press the delete button. If it doesn't get selected, we have to press on and keep on deleting all the circles which we have made. Then comes the 3-point circle, which means that you have to first specify one point, then the second point, and the third point will specify where you want to end your circle. Again, first point, second point, and the third point. So this is how we can make 3-point circle. You can edit the diameter accordingly, which was stated previously. In order to delete all, select all and press the delete button. Now move on to the 3 tangent. So for 3 tangent, you will be needing 3 entities. Let's suppose that be a line chain. This be the first line, the second line, and the third line. Now select on the 3 tangent, select the first line, the second line, and the third. So this circle will be tangent to all of these lines. If you want the dimensions not to appear, so from the graphics tool, you can click on the sketcher display filters and you can uncheck the display dimensions. Secondly, you can see that there are certain constraints that are present. For example, this circle is tangent to this line, so a small t is appearing here. Same is the case with this, a small t is appearing here and so on. If you don't want to display the dimension, the constraints, you can uncheck the display constraints. So they will disappear. Similarly, this is the grid. If you click on it, the grid will appear, and if you uncheck it, the grid will disappear. So this is how you can draw a 3 tangent circle. Again, select it and press the delete button. Let's move on to the arc now. The arc is just the same as the circle. There are different types of arcs as we have studied for the circle. 3-point arc. Identify the first point, the second point, and the third point will be identifying the radius of the arc. Similarly, this. Then you can change the radius of the arc here, as you have already been told that this shows the radius, so you can change the radius accordingly. Let's suppose this be 33, okay? So you can change the radius of the arc. The other type of arc is center and ends. First, you have to define one center, then the first endpoint, and then the second endpoint. Define the first, define the center, the first endpoint, and the second endpoint. So this is how you can make different arcs. To clear the working area, select, click on the right button of the mouse, drag it, and then click on the delete button from the keyboard. For three tangent arc, again, you have to identify three surfaces to which you will be making the arc tangent. Let these be the three surfaces. Select first, select second, and select third. So this arc is tangent to these three entities. Again, if it isn't clear to you and you want to disable the dimensions, so you can uncheck this box and you can clearly see the arc which is tangent to the three lines provided. Okay, so the next arc is about concentric, so that is just the same as the circle, for which you will be needing a center point. If you don't have a center point, the concentric arc will not work. Just look at it as I have made the command active, but it isn't working somewhere here because I don't have a center here. Now, as I click on the center, you can see that I can make arcs of any radius, all of them having the same center. So this is how it works. Again, to delete, you have to select all and press the delete button. Select this and press the delete button. Then comes the conic arc. You have to define the first point, the second, and you can make the arc of any shape you want. And you can adjust the angles and the radii at the same time. You can adjust the angles from here and the radii from here. So this is how you can make the conic arc. Okay, so let's delete this one. You're all requested to kindly practice these before going further into the other sketching tools. Now let's work on the ellipse. There are two methods of making ellipse in the Creo. One is axis ends ellipse, the other is center and axis ellipse. Axis end ellipse means that the length of your line will specify the diameter of the major axis. And the next point where you right click will identify the radius of your minor axis. So this is how it works. Identify the first point, the second point, which appears to be the diameter of the major axis, and then click on where you want to end the ellipse. You can change the dimensions here. This gives the diameter of the major axis, and this gives the diameter of the minor axis. So you can simply double click on it, change the dimensions, and press enter. The other type of ellipse is center and axis ellipse. That means you have to first specify a center point and then the end points. That will be appearing as the diameter of the major axis, and then you can identify the radius of the minor axis. So this is how center and axis ellipse work. Again, you can change the dimensions accordingly. So this is how you can make ellipse. Again, select all, press the delete button. Now to move on to the spline. Spline has the first point, then there are a number of interpolation points, and then we are having an end point. So it isn't having any radius. Simply, if you want to change the shape, you can click on one of the points and you can drag it accordingly. So this is how you can change the shape of the spline. Again, if I want to make a spline here, this specifies the first point, then there are a number of interpolation points, and then the end point. And in order to change the shape, we can simply drag on any of the point we want accordingly. Again, to delete, select all and press the delete button. Now comes the fillet and the chamfer. So fillet commands are basically used if you have read about the designing of table or whatever. So you can see that whenever tables are designed, its sharp edges are made circular so that it isn't dangerous. So if you have, for example, made a simple corner rectangle and you want its edges to be circular, so you can use fillet command for that. That can either be circular trim or simple circular or elliptical and elliptical trim. Let's work on the circular first. Select the circular, select the first point and the second point, and then you can see that edge has become circular. You can zoom in it from the graphic tools available. Click on the zoom in button and click here, plus make the rectangle or drag it and release. So you can see that that portion has been zoomed in. Now in circular, you can see that the construction lines are here. They aren't removed. If we use the circular trim, these construction lines will also vanish. So let's work on the circular trim for the next edge. Select one point, the other point. And if we want to zoom in, you can see that there are no construction lines available. So this is the basic difference between the circular trim and circular. This is circular, this is circular trim. Same is the case with elliptical. For elliptical, click on the first edge and the second edge, and you can see that it becomes circular. This is how it works. The main difference between circular and elliptical is that if you want to make this portion or this edge more circular than this one, so you will be using the elliptical option. Click on here and here. So you can see that it becomes like this. If I turn off the display dimensions, so you can clearly see here. For circular, you will be having equal circular shape on the both sides of the edge. And for elliptical, you will be having a smooth on one side and a bit less smoother on the other side. So this is how we can work on that. The same difference goes for the elliptical and elliptical trim. In elliptical, you can see that the dimension, your construction lines are still present. And if you work on the elliptical trim, then the construction lines will also vanish. Let's delete this one. Again, let's make a corner rectangle and then come to the chamfer command. Chamfer is just the same as the fillet, but the difference is that in chamfer, we make the edges joined by a straight line. Let's suppose I have selected this point and this point, so they will be joined by a straight line. You can see the difference again. There, the construction lines are present, and if you want to work on the chamfer trim, the construction lines won't be available. So that is the main difference between these. So this is how you can use the sketching commands. We will be continuing the remaining commands in the part 2 of lecture 1 video. You are all requested to practice these commands as much as possible. Thank you.